So we will soon have available to us the first injectable antiretroviral long-acting combinations, injectable cabotegravir and rilpivirine. These are agents that will be given first as oral agents, and then if tolerated and people have virologic suppression, we'll be able to switch them to injections that are given every 4 weeks or maybe every 8 weeks with a couple of intramuscular injections in their gluteus medius. Unfortunately, people will have to come into our offices in order to get the shots, and they'll probably need to adhere to the injection regimen at the desired frequency. These are long-acting products, and there is the concern that individuals who miss their injections, they are potentially at risk for developing resistance. However, for people who don't like taking pills, or for people who associate the pill taking as a reminder of HIV infection and stigma associated with that, we'll finally have an alternative for them that may help them adhere better. So, first injectable agents. We've got some other oral agents that are further or not as far along in development, further from the clinic. One called Islatravir is a drug that's like a nucleoside but has a couple of additional properties. It's called a nucleoside reverse transcriptase translocation inhibitor. This looks like a very potent drug that may be given once a week or may be able to be co-formulated with another agent to have an effective two-drug combination. And then we've got, again, further along, a capsid inhibitor. The capsid inhibitors work by inhibiting multiple steps in the HIV life cycle, and it appears that the first agent to be tested in this class has a lot of activity at a very low dose and may be formulatable either in a pill that could be taken maybe once a week or as another injection.